I'm sure you're familiar with the term pivot. It basically means repositioning yourself at one side while also remaining grounded on the other side. In 2018, a pivot is what we did in our economic development department. Up until this year, we were solely focused on retention. That is what we felt was important to us, and we've done that since 2011. Our retention efforts have garnered a number of results for the city. Recognizing that and continuing the growth of economic development in St. Charles and the region, we decided to pivot and add recruitment to our efforts. So in 2018, through the efforts of the Marks Nelson Study, we are going out and doing more recruitment of industries to come to St. Charles. A good example of that is the Aerospace Supplier and Defense Summit that's going to be taking place in Seattle. We are joining the Missouri Partnership and the Export Division of the Missouri Department of Economic Development to attend this trade show so we can recruit those industries looking to expand in the defense area to come to St. Charles to grow with us, to be a part of our aerospace and defense industry. This effort actually is a win-win-win strategy. It's a win for St. Charles because we get high-paying jobs, expansion of our industry base, which is important to not only St. Charles, but the St. Louis metropolitan region. It's important to our aerospace and defense industries, like a Boeing, an LMI Aerospace, and a Patriot Machine, because that provides more suppliers to them, which hopefully lowers their operating costs. And it's a win for the supplier, because they get the benefits of a great business climate in Missouri and a great location in the city of St. Charles. Win, win, win is how we believe in growth in economic development and the city of St. Charles. See you next week.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Regional Investors Breakfast. I'm David Leeser. I'm the Director of Economic Development. I hope you enjoyed breakfast. I hope you enjoyed the networking. As you saw, something we're going to be talking about today is pivot. And that video you just saw is a corner piece of our pivot. We use the word pivot because I will tell you a little bit about myself. I honestly, to God, I spent 20 years as a high school and grade school basketball referee. I wore the stripes. And so if anybody knows about pivot, and basketball, how basketball should be run, and how you operate in a basketball, I know, because with 20 years of experience in basketball, I know how to do the pivot, I know how to teach pivot, I am the best at doing the pivot. So what we're going to work here is showing you the basketball skills, excuse me?
Stop right there. If anyone can talk about pivoting on this campus in basketball, it's myself, not an old ex-referee.
Okay, I'm maybe a little old, but not, okay, I'm an ex too, so all right. But wait, first of all, who are you and why are you here crashing my party?
Well, I'm Lance Randall. I'm the head men's basketball coach here at Lindenwood University. It's my job.
You get more applause than I do.
It's my job to teach smart players how to pivot and adjust.
Well, since you think you're the expert, I'll let you teach them about pivot. However, you should know this. First of all, we got a bunch of economic developers in this crowd, so talk slow and do not use big words.
I'm sure most of them can keep up.
All right, Mr. Expert, show us about the pivot.
Well, there's no question the pivot is a fundamental move. It's an outstanding fundamental move. And what we do is when our players are in the paint, our big guys especially, we teach them to pivot, to face up, and see the basket because it's very hard to score when you can't see the goal. So the important thing of the pivot is that you keep one foot down, fundamentally strong. We keep it down, and it's sound to the ground. It provides a foundation for us. And the rest of us, we're pivoting, and we're able to survey the court, see the entire court, and also see all the players that are out there.
So you're using what we're doing. We're being fundamental on one side and moving on the other. So now I'm an expert. So since you have crashed my party, I got a great idea. How about when the season starts, I crash your party, and I'll teach your guys how to play basketball, and I can coach on the sidelines.
Well, it sounds like you're doing a little comedy on the side. That's hilarious. I think we'll hold off
okay.
on that.
Now, first of all, as a former referee, that's technical one. Don't push me on this, okay? But you're more than welcome to stay and learn from me if you want.
No, that's all right. I got some recruiting to do.
Recruiting?
Yeah.
Hey, you know, I still have eligibility left. I'm their coach. I can do it. Recruit me.
Come to think of it, I think we're out of scholarships now.
All right, that's technical number two. You are out of here.
Oh, there's Mayor Faith. I guess if it's, hi, Mayor Faith. If it's happening in St. Charles, and on Lindenwood campus here. And there's my boss, Dr. Sean Rock. Yes. So I don't know if you've heard, but Lindenwood provides real experience for real success.
Well, thank you.
All right, thank you.
Hey, thanks, Coach. Yeah, appreciate thanks, it. Ladies and gentlemen,
thanks,
Lance
everybody.
Randall, head coach of the Lindenwood Lions basketball team. All right, so you've learned about the pivot, and you learned what we're going to do. As we said last year, what we want you to do is do not turn off your phones. We want you to pull your phones out, take pictures, take selfies. We want this thing promoted. We have 450 people who RSVP'd, so we appreciate your attendance on that, and we want you to help promote us. So please, Twitter and Facebook and whatever else you do, use our Twitter handle at growstcharles.com, and also hashtag it, it's happening, STC. I've got to get my notes together here. I do want to say, but before we start, something like this can't just happen in a day. It takes us a long time and a lot of effort. And I want to say some thank yous to some people here who helped us get this done, because I get the benefit of standing up here and just talking. And those who know me know that I can stand and talk for a long, long time. But my mayor over there says amen. Okay. But I do want to acknowledge, and I want you to thank Susie King, Travis Wilson, my intern Ethan DeBreck, intern a couple of years ago, Brandon Bradshaw, Carla Bray, Jeremy Lupkin, Beth Norville, who runs our media operations, Jim Pruitt, Aaron Phillips. I hope I haven't forgotten anybody on that. Also, I want to thank this facility is phenomenal, is it not? Is this not a great place? So I want to make sure that Bob Cook and his staff also gets acknowledged, because we couldn't do something like this and get this many people without all the assistance of my staff and the people at the City of St. Charles and Bob Cook and his staff. So please give them a round of applause for me. Okay. I'll say the same thing as I said last year. It's my honor and pleasure to introduce somebody who actually does not need an introduction, because if you do not know this person, you're probably hiding under a rock, and you need to know this person. So without further ado, let me introduce my boss, my mayor, your mayor, the Honorable Sally Faith. Mayor? Thank you. Appreciate you coming up.
Well, good morning, good morning. I can't see you, but I know you're there. I really want to thank David and his staff and for all that has been done pulling this together over the years. And I'm getting choked up about it, you know. And I want to thank each of you. Now, I have a little speech here, and David wrote it. So if there's anything wrong, or if I tell a bad joke, it's David's fault. All right. Good morning and welcome to the City of St. Charles Regional Investors Breakfast. This is our showcase event to not only celebrate our successes and your successes, but to give you an opportunity to only use our plan for the future and be an active part of all of the plan. I want to acknowledge and thank Dr. Michael Shonrock, and I love it. I go somewhere, and I know he's there because I walk in and I hear, "If it's happening," and then I pick up the rest. Okay. And so we have teamwork here, don't we, sir? I'm glad to have this hosting us today. And as you have experienced, the Scheidegger Center and Lindenwood University are great hosts for all types of events. So keep that in mind in your daily life. Also, I'd like to thank Dr. Shonrock and his team for putting all this together. And I think I made a comment this morning that, you know, I was up all night cooking the breakfast. And someone said to me, "Well, you did a good job cutting the lawn, too." I said, "Oh, that was at midnight. I did that." So I am a truthful person, but all right, I can dream. I want to personally thank everyone, the sponsors for today's event, and David is going to recognize them. And I'm not going to read all of them, but David is, and give him more oomph. But what I'd like to say, and I'd like for us to do, is to clap and thank the sponsors of this event. I would like at this time to recognize a few dignitaries and friends who are with us today. For the sake of time, I just ask representatives of these groups to please stand, and I'd ask that we all hold the applause at one time. Now, if there's anyone left when we end here that's not standing, I want you to stand too, all right? Okay, members of the St. Charles City Council, members of the City of St. Charles Economic Development Commission, representatives of County Executive Steve Ellman and County Council members, representatives of our state and federal legislative delegation. I saw a lot here today, this morning, and they were, I think they had the eggs and the ham sandwich. I just wanted you to know that. Okay, mayors and other elected officials from our neighborhood communities and our economic development allies, EDC Partner for Business and Community, the St. Louis Regional Chamber. I can see now. I can see a little better. Okay, the interchange of Fifth Street. Up. I turned too many pages. I like Fifth Street, too. I really do. Missouri Department of Economic Development and the Missouri Partnership. Can we give them a big hand? Thank you. All right. We in St. Charles are proud and thankful that growth is taking place. We talked to a few people out with coffee, and things are moving, and they're moving forward, and there's a momentum. My philosophy is that momentum is there, and I think that many, many of you feel that, and we need to keep it going, and that's important. I believe one of the reasons for this growth pattern is our ability to deal with change. I don't like a lot of change, but I like change in the city. Now, does that mean I have a lot of orange cones put up? Yes, it does. But when they come down, it's a good deal. While change is something difficult, it is inevitable. However, to be successful, not only must you embrace change, but ensure that change will benefit and be the benefit and executed and done. You know, I hear about the cloud in the sky. I see clouds, and I know there's the IT technology cloud. But, you know, I have dreams for the future, as you do for your business and for your growth and for the growth of the Lindenwood College and Lindenwood. And it's just, we've got to have dreams. So we all have dreams, as you do. Now, for example, let me point out just some of the changes that have taken place since I took office in 2011. Streets of St. Charles open, University Commons open, westbound Blanchette Bridge was updated, the trolley returned. I talked to some people today, and they said they rode the trolley, and I'm so glad they did, because I almost threatened them if they didn't, and they were happy. I'm so glad. The interchange at Fifth Street and I-70 was completed. We updated our parks, Prop P passed by the voters, and it passed soundly, and with that, it was Prop P was changing the parks. I don't know if anyone's been to Blanchette, and also to Wapahorse, but you will never see me on any of those rides. So if you're waiting for a good shot, it ain't gonna happen. But I love them, and I know somebody that went down one of them. I think Larry Dabrowski went down before it opened. And I don't know that there's evidence, but he did. I heard that. Okay, but thanks to the voters of the city, we updated. The parks were up, and thank you, Mary Lee, and the Parks Department and the Parks Board. And then the rest of it is stormwater, clean water. We can't keep putting water in the Missouri River, even though it doesn't look very clean. We can't keep putting water that is not truly, I think FEMA and everyone says, you gotta change that. So we're, not that we're doing it now. Now don't go tell everybody we're putting dirty water in the Missouri. But we're making sure for the future that we're meeting all the requirements as we have in the past. All right, but I thank the voters. We are working on improving our wastewater program, stormwater, which is another part of Prop B, and the Katy Trail was connected to the Great Rivers Greenway Trail near Highway 370. Opened a new extension to the Central Greenway at 94 and Page, Great Rivers Greenway, and a bike path. It's right by my house. I thought, well, when I went there and cut the ribbon, I thought, well, I think I'll just go here all the time. I haven't been there yet, but I'm thinking about it. All right, and Fifth Street was improved. And I want to, but this is a snapshot, and I want to clear the air. All right. Now, Elliot, despite what Elliot Davis said, the city is not building a $1 million sign on Highway 70, and we never planned on doing a $1 million sign, but I have to say, he's coming to meet me again this afternoon, so stay tuned. But this is just a small snapshot of what has taken place. These changes, while important, only occur because we, one, planned them. Two, they were done with a large number of partners. I think I'm running out of time. I believe that you will see today is our commitment to change for the better. Change for the worse is not acceptable, or for not being good. All right. And is strong, and we are planning for that improvement. However, for us to be successful, we need your support, your partnership. And partnerships is what does it. The municipalities in St. Charles County, working with the county executive, Steve Ellman. And so I invite everyone here today to see how and think about how you can help us achieve our goals to continue and to make St. Charles the premier community for families and businesses. In conclusion, I know that's what you were waiting for. In conclusion, on behalf of the City of St. Charles, I want to welcome each and every one of you and hope today's presentation will encourage you and uplift you to join me in telling everyone that if it's happening, it's happening in St. Charles. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor.
The next person I'd like to introduce, and I do this on purpose for, first of all, ladies come first, and second of all, I'd rather you follow the mayor than me try to follow the mayor. So that's probably the most difficult part of my job is trying to follow the mayor and all that she does for us. A good friend of ours who helped us put this together, who's helped us with University Commons and a number of things, and is our, as I tell, my fourth largest employer, which is also important to me also. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Michael Schonrock, president of Lindenwood University.
Thank you very much. David, certainly of the basketball recruits I've watched over the years, you were the most recent. Thank you all for being here this morning. How many of you are Lindenwood graduates? Lindenwood graduates, raise your hand. How many of you want to be Lindenwood graduates? All right. Well, we're thrilled that you're here on behalf of our trustees and the entire Lindenwood family. We're thrilled that you're here today. Thank you. You know, Mayor, thank you for your thoughts about change. There's one thing that's constant in higher education, it's change. It's going to continue to change. And I'm reminded, you used to have a poster in my office some time ago. It was a poster of a diaper hanging on a clothesline outside, drying, and the caption said, change is good. Well, I'm reminded that sometimes change is difficult, but it is something that's inevitable as we go forward. We're thrilled you're here, and I'm glad you talked about our partnerships. Lindenwood University wants to do whatever it can to continue to be a good partner in the greater area, certainly in this county. within the city, because we know how important that is. The other part is, as we focus our future as an institution, we really want to find ways of doing a couple things. One, we've got a lot of great students here from all over the world and all over our states and all over our nation. And what we want to try to do is provide them better opportunities for internships and practicums. So help us, as you are investing, to find ways we can invest in those students, because we want them to stay. We want them to be part of this community, and we find that over and over again. Recently, our university, and we thought it would be helpful to get a little bit of an insight of our investments overall, because all of you are investors, and thank you for investing. Many of you, I think I've seen you at graduations over a period of time. I always love that. I tell the parents at graduation, you know, congratulations as your son and daughter walk across the stage. Watch your son and daughter walk across the stage, because that's been a great investment. But as you walk, as they walk across, just remind yourself you're getting a salary increase for just a moment. And I think that's one of the most important things. But we know what investments mean as an institution and those of you investing. But I thought it was interesting. We did, for the first time in a long time, a firm outside to look at our economic impact, because we know we impact. We talk about economic engine as universities, but we should be good investors and good impact. And I thought this was interesting. We just got this data just recently. Development Strategies is the group we worked with. But Lindenwood University as a whole, in the greater St. Louis area, provides over $450 million of impact, which isn't too bad. About almost 1,000 jobs, 1,500 part-time jobs, over 4,000 student jobs. So we are providing a lot in terms of our investment. Just in the county itself, we provide about $300 million of economic impact, directly, indirectly. So we understand the value of investing back in our community, but we also want you to know how much we appreciate your continued investments. You know, I love the students at the institution. They make me smile every day. And I always share it. I share this. We're going to be celebrating 10 years at the Scheidner. Isn't this a beautiful facility? Let's give the facility a round of applause. It is a beautiful facility. But I'm reminded that a lot of times we bring in shows. This is the first year we're bringing two student shows. I have no idea what the groups are called, but I know they're probably cool. When the Beatles broke up, music died for me. So that shows my age a little bit. But I remember when I first came here, as we're getting ready to celebrate our 10 year, but a couple years back, I came in and I got to watch the Doobie Brothers. Remember the Doobie Brothers? They were good, right? And I went backstage. I had a chance to go backstage. And I still had their first album. And I thought that was neat. So I just wanted to show it to them. And I went backstage and won't mention all the ones that were there. I said, do you remember this album? And one smiled at me, goes, well, that was the 70s. We don't remember much of the 70s. And I said, well, that's good to know. And so we had a nice conversation about that. But it reminds us, as things go, things change. But as I was kind of walking out, a young woman who was a student here who just graduated at Lindenwood University said, she goes, oh, by the way, President Shadrach, why do they call themselves the Doobie Brothers? And I said, Google it. So I reminded that things change, but for the good reasons, too. Bottom line is, thank you for your investment. Thank you for your continued investment. If it's happening, it's happening. Thank you very much. Welcome again. Bye-bye.
Dr. Romer, thank you. Appreciate it. I'll let you even have one of those. Thank you again. We talked about my staff and staff at the city who helped make this, and the mayor talked about this also. But honestly, to pull something like this off, we need sponsors, we need support. And I want to take this time also to recognize those people who are willing to commit their time and dollars to help put this together. So what I'm going to do is I'll read all the sponsors by their names. Would you please stand? Then I ask everybody, please, after everybody stand, I'll have you just give applause for everybody. So members of the corporate group, Cushman Wakefield, Thomas Realty Group, Brownsmith Wallace, First State Bank, The Millstone Company, Cullinan Properties, Spire, Cecil Mueller, AT&T, and the Rockwood Group. Thank you very much. Appreciate it, ladies and gentlemen. Well, they always say the part of a good speech is to tell them what you're going to tell them what you just told them. So what we basically are going to do right here is we're briefly going to go over what has taken place. The mayor has touched upon a lot of it, but there's some things that has happened that we are very proud of that our partners have helped us do in the past few years. But the one thing I'm going to divert a little bit on, Susie King, who's my AA, Actually, I tell people, I've got the title, but she's the boss. Everybody knows that. So we were talking, and I think we're the only city in the St. Louis metropolitan area that does something like this. And so we're the best at it, clearly. And so we were talking about it, and there's an old saying that says that you enjoy the shade of a tree from people who planted the seed years ago. And we calculated it. This is our 22nd annual breakfast that we're doing this. Previously, it was called the St. Charles Real Estate Breakfast. I came in, we changed it to the Real Estate Investment Breakfast. So we've been doing it for 22 years. I do want to acknowledge Nadine Boone in the audience. She's the one that started this 22 years ago. And so Nadine, if you're in, please stand. Let us thank you for starting it and all. So. So anyway, we've had a lot of investment, a lot of success, and a lot of things going on. One of the biggest things that has taken place in the city of St. Charles recently, and I hope you saw this announcement, BH International, based in Spain, moving their U.S. headquarters from California to St. Charles. We're going to create 50 new jobs, 75,000 square feet. And again, economic development is the ultimate in team game. They came to us, they looked at what we were talking about and what we could show and how we can show off the city of St. Charles and St. Charles County region. But in basketball, when you pivot, you have to hand off things. That's the other thing that we're going to do. Just to make sure everybody's staying awake, I'm going to do stuff like this when we pivot. All right? You can't throw it back. But, so we pivoted. And we shared this project with our friends at the Missouri Department of Economic Development, and with the Missouri Department or Missouri Partnership. And Dennis Pruitt from the partnership is the one who took charge of this. And because of our partnership with them and with Scott Drocknick at the Workforce Development Center, we were able to land them to move their headquarters out of California into the city of St. Charles. They are estimating just moving to Missouri, there's a 40% operational cost savings just to be here. So if you want an incentive, there's a good incentive for you. The other thing that I don't have in my slide, but I got permission to announce it today, ESSA Health is moving into 1551 Wall Street. They're taking 10,000 square feet there. That's a primary care service. They're going to have doctors and nurses there with over 15 years of experience in the St. Louis metropolitan area. They're going to open at the end of July. And so we want to acknowledge Keith and Joe Schneider for bringing them into the St. Louis area, into the St. Charles area, by the way, and also being part of our overall health cluster. So we've got those coming in. The other thing that was taking place is retail is still growing in the city of St. Charles. That's something very important to all of us. If you take a look at what happens here in St. Charles, what's vital is the fact that it's not just one area. We've got growth in retail that's taking place at Streets of St. Charles with Brulé Boutique, with the Drury Hotel, and then at the end of this month, True by Hilton will be opening at Streets of St. Charles, so that's a great bookends for that. You saw a new Cedarhurst going into University Commons. You saw the Joint Chiropractic going into University Commons. We got Aw Shirts that went into Frenchtown. We got new businesses along Main Street. We've got companies all over the place, and matter of fact, what makes all of us happy is the fact that Donut King reopened on First Capitol Drive, so our sugar high has been met. But what drives retail is also housing, and housing is very important to us. Our population continues to grow. And you've seen this slide before. This is not something new to you for the most part, but what is new to you is at the very bottom, and that's the Sanford property. By the end of last year, Lombardo Homes bought that. They're going to convert that into 235 units into the city of St. Charles. So it's new housing that's taking place. But let me also ask you again to take a look at that map. It's not housing that's going in one area. We have housing in Newtown. We have housing at Sanford. We have housing south of 70 and 364. We have housing on our east. We have housing on our west. We have the space to put the housing. We are not centrally locating our housing, which means more families, more growth, and more millennials into our area. But we also have our technology corridor going. To the thanks of Randy Schilling and his support with Greg Pressman at the EDC,
the OPO continues to grow and prosper to the point where the OPO itself is full, completely full. Randy is now has moved across the street into the OPO annex. And so he's got companies in there like Parameter Security, Fusion 5, Clark Worth Clark, Good Meets World, a lot of cutting edge companies. His goal is to turn that into a technology corridor, because that will be our transformational project. We told you that about 4 years ago at our regional investors breakfast. Randy Schilling is making it come true. We are becoming a transformational project for us. And I gotta, if you don't mind me, give me a little pat on the back for ourselves. This is something that I keep telling staff, it's not about me, it's about us. This is about us. This is, we were reaccredited last year as an accredited economic development organization by the International Economic Development Council. There's only about 60 organizations in the US, in North America, that have achieved this designation. So we're very rare about that. So we got it in 2014. We re-upped in 2017 through another rigorous report system. I know Jim Fram, who's here, who also did that through his community in Hot Springs and in Tulsa, and he can vouch for you, it's not easy to get. So we are, like I said, one of 60. We are one of five in the state of Missouri. We are one of three in the St. Louis metropolitan area. Our friends at the St. Louis Partnership is one, and Greg Preston at the EDC is one. We are the only community in the state of Missouri that has an AEDO designation. So that's something that we're proud of. In my eyes, I say this helps us be the best of the best. It keeps us sharp. Now, everybody knows about this, and I try not to get political on this stuff. And if you like Donald Trump, okay, if you hate Donald Trump, okay, and I will tell you this from the bottom of my heart, I really don't care. Because the bottom line is this: when the President of the United States comes to your town and talks into your community, that's an economic development boom. Because your community is on CNN, and your community is on Fox News, and your community is on MSNBC, and your community is on CBS. We couldn't have bought the advertisement that this got for our city and the promotion we got for this city. We were all over the place with this. And so, you know, like him or not, it's always good when the president comes to your town and showcases you. But we have to look to our future. This is our pivot. Please catch that. If I hear somebody gets hurt. Okay, dive for it. Dive for it. But we are going to pivot for our future. And it was kind of interesting. A good friend of mine who's actually sitting in the audience, we were talking recently, and he looked at me and he says, "What is this pivot stuff?" He goes, "You're Mr. Retention. That's all you talk about. We can't get you to shut up about retention." He says, "When we talked, you said retention, retention, retention." And I looked him right in the eyes and I said, "You're right. I was Mr. Retention, and I still am." And actually, it's not me, it's us. We are deep into retention. But we got retention down. We understand retention. We've got retention really, really good. But the study that was done through the EDC showed us that we have to pivot. We have to change our ways if we are going to continue to grow and prosper and move forward. So we are repositioning ourselves, and we are going to focus on some recruitment. Not that we haven't done recruitment in the past. It just hasn't been our primary focus. We've done some recruitment with PharmaMedica. We did recruitment with Cisco. Now, Cisco is an existing company, but we were competing against Illinois to get Cisco to stay here. So we focused on getting that Cisco recruitment here. Patterson Mold expanded here. We recruited Old Time Produce with the help of Bob Millstone to get them there. But we recognized that we really, really needed to do more. So we did a pivot. The video you saw before when we talked about Pivot talks about a trade show we attended with our partners at the Missouri Partnership and the department, the International Division of the Department of Economic Development. It was called the Aerospace and Defense Supplier Summit in Seattle. We attended that. We were part of that. We are recruiting those suppliers to Patriot Machine, to Boeing, to LMI, companies who can come here and recruit and grow here and prosper here. I want you to take a look at this, because you're going to see something here that is more rare than the abominable snowman or the Loch Ness monster. You may want to take a picture of this, because you may not see this ever again in your life. What you see in front of you, ladies and gentlemen, is a picture of David Leaser without a necktie. I question whether I should bring that up or not.
because I just wanted to show you, I can go places without a necktie. It's not easy, but I can do that. There was also companies from the state of Missouri and St. Charles County were there, so we were recruiting those companies there. We have reached out now to site locators through our partnerships that we have with the Missouri Partnership and the St. Louis Regional Chamber. Just this year, we've done site visits, site meetings with Missouri Partnership in Cleveland, with site locators in Cleveland and Pittsburgh and Indianapolis and Columbus. And we are there pushing the brand of St. Charles and St. Charles County to these site locators. This is a relationship business. That's how you get them. A meeting like that will not get us anywhere except a beginning. And that's what we're looking for, is our beginning. And we do this with partnerships so we can go with meet people like that. My job now is to follow up with these people. I'm going to go back to Indianapolis and meet with them. We got a trip to Atlanta again later this fall. But we do this because I also understand that not everybody knows who St. Charles is. There are 16 St. Charleses in the United States. So differentiating ourselves is important. We're the largest. We're the best. But everybody knows Missouri. And so we have to use our partners to make sure that they understand who Missouri is and we're a part of Missouri. So I'm going to ask my friend, Steve Johnson, who's the president and CEO of the Missouri Partnership, to please come forward and join me here at the podium. And we're going to talk about the Missouri Partnership, what they do, how they assist us and our partners and other communities in the state of Missouri in recruiting and getting the name of Missouri out and our community out. So Steve Johnson. Kind of nice sitting here. People probably may not even know who the Missouri Partnership is. So why don't you explain who the Missouri Partnership is?
Sure, be glad to. Good morning, everybody. First of all, I have never seen a picture of myself that big. And I'm pretty sure you never asked my permission to scrape that off our website, or I would have said no. Missouri Partnership was created a little over 10 years ago in Governor Blunt's administration. It was formed during that time period. It was created as a public-private economic development partnership to kind of be the point for the state of Missouri in the outreach, the marketing, and the business attraction. That's just one piece of economic development, but that's the piece we lead, and so we like to refer to ourselves as a purpose-built organization. We were built exclusively to do business attraction, but to do it in partnership with the Department of Economic Development, and obviously in a partnership with communities and economic development organizations around the state. And I've been on the community side most of my career. I've been at the partnership a little over 3 years, and I have no trouble saying that companies choose to locate in communities, not necessarily states. Now, we have to be there to back you up and be supportive, but the business is driven by regions and communities.
Yeah. Very good, and you're doing a good job. Talk about how you get communities like us to go on recruiting trips and how you develop the recruiting trips.
Well, we put out a pretty ambitious calendar every year, and I was thinking about this, and it's one of these old sayings that I've heard forever, and so I looked it up on the internet while you were talking, so I know it's true. The old, the famous bank robber from a long time ago, Willie Sutton, and you've probably all heard this, was asked one time why he robs banks. That's where the money is. And so that's not a real sophisticated marketing strategy, but we try to go where the people are that we hope to work with over the course of time. So you went to the Aerospace Summit up in D.C. We try to create a presence where individuals who are influential in that particular industry, you try to create collisions or intersections with them. But we spend a lot of time cultivating relationships with site location consultants that David talked about. And the reason we do that is pretty simple. And if I start going too long, just kick me. In the course of a year, at least 40, probably more like 50, just a little over 50% of the deals done around the United States are going to be done by site location consultants. This is a pretty small group of individuals around the country, and some of them are in law firms, some in accounting firms, some are standalone boutique firms, that companies engage to help them find the best location for whatever their project is. And the reason these people are so important, first of all, we know where to find them. Um, we, But the story I like to tell, and if you'll
keep going,
Nadine, it's good to see you across. I've known Nadine for a long, long time, and she'll probably know who this person is. But when I first got in the business a long time ago, in the early to mid-80s, I was in Jefferson City with the Chamber there. We did a Maytag deal. Within a course of 3 years, we did a deal with Maytag and a deal with Johnson Controls by the same site location consultant. Later, when I was with the Kansas City Area Development Council, we did the Harley-Davidson deal with the same site location consultant. 2 years ago, when we did a million-square-foot distribution center with Dollar Tree that went to Warrensburg, we worked with the same site selection consultant. And we've got a 1,500-person project that Missouri is competing for right now with the same individual. So it's a relationship that goes, and I'm not saying that I located these, but the organization I was with at the time was influential in these projects. But it's these relationships that are built over time that are trusting, and they're not going to win the project for you, but they'll give you a bite at the apple.
You know, we talked about partnerships, and I think it's important our partnership with you and with Rob Dixon and DED, but the one partner I forgot to mention on all this is the Hawthorne Foundation. I know that Steve Oslika is in the audience. Steve, if you are here, please stand. Okay, I can't see anyway. So thank you, Steve, wherever you're at. But let's talk about the partnership with the Hawthorne Foundation, too.
Yeah, because that's very important. So the Hawthorne Foundation was created by Senator Bond when he was governor 35 years ago. Steve just coordinated a great celebratory event a couple of months ago to celebrate 35 years of Hawthorne. But Hawthorne was set up as a driven apolitical, it is violently apolitical organization whose purpose is really to support the sitting governor. Whoever the sitting governor is and whatever his or her economic development agenda is, that's what Hawthorne is there to support. So right now, you know, if you have a chance to talk to Steve, he'll tell you about the different initiatives that are going on at the statewide level that Hawthorne is supporting. We were created as a subsidiary of the Hawthorne Foundation. So Hawthorne has a contract for marketing services with the Department of Economic Development. We then have a contract with Hawthorne to provide those services. And so Hawthorne supplements the state funding that comes to them through DED, which then flows to us, but they supplement that with private sector resources as well. So that's how it becomes the public-private economic development partnership.
I think that's important to know because we are supporters of the Missouri partnership, but our support financially goes through the Hawthorne Foundation. And we're very pleased that we're a part of that group. They've done a really good job, and Steve has done, and his group has done a very good job also. Anything else you want to talk about on the Missouri partnership while you got the stage? Unless you want to talk about pivots.
No, I don't. Yeah, you see how tall I am? Basketball's not my game, and I'd probably blow out my other knee. No, I think it's just great to be here. I just want to say thank you for the support you give economic development for the city of St. Charles. Mayor, you're a rock star as far as recruiting business. Once you get hold of them, you don't let go. It's a very competitive business. It's very competitive, and once again, it's part of economic development. It's not all of it, but it's the part that can really make a noticeable difference in a community and a state.
Very good. Thank you, Steve. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Johnson. Here, I'll even let you have a ball. Thank you. We talked about retail, and we still do retail recruitment. We've always done somewhat of a retail recruitment, so we have not failed or gotten away from that, but we do more than just that. Here we go. This year, as in past, we went to the International Council of Shopping Centers Recon Show in Las Vegas. This is something we've done for years. We are there, we go that, do this for a number of different reasons. Again, it's a relationship building. We promote the city of St. Charles and St. Charles County. We also push out our sites, our retail sites, everything from Streets of St. Charles and U Commons to Newtown, to Zumbel Corners, to Frenchtown and to historic Main Street. But also we are there to support our brokers because honestly, they are the people who can secure the deals. I can't negotiate a deal in terms of price and the like. So we are there supporting Desco. We are there supporting L3. We are there supporting Cullinan Properties. We are there supporting Cecil Mueller. We're supporting those people who get those relationships in place to get investment in here. The good thing about this is two things, especially this year. It's a long-term relationship, as Steven mentioned before. This lady to the right, is Linda Lund. She's the VP of Real Estate for Panda Express. I walked into her booth. We were talking. I said, you know, I know it's confidential, but you're going to be hopefully building one of your Panda Expresses in St. Charles. And she says, yeah, we haven't signed the deal yet. We think we're going to get the deal signed, but we're going to move forward on that. I said, okay, let me know when we can push it out. And she goes, now. So if anybody knows me, they know when you say now, that means now. I grabbed my phone, all right, and I went full-blown Twitter and LinkedIn, and I had a picture of that. I had heard saying Panda Express is coming to St. Charles. Now, if you want to know where, it's the old Chevy site. It's got the fence around it. They're getting ready to raise that building right now. So they can't back out. It's on Twitter, all right? They cannot make Twitter a liar. The other relationship we have, again, is we meet with other real estate people, and just by pure luck, I met with another broker who's a major retailer in the nation. He had heard of Missouri, never heard of St. Charles, and he even said that, I'm probably going to come to the St. Louis area, probably going to look at a place like Fenton. And I go, well, why not St. Charles? And he goes, well, what do you got in St. Charles? So I went streets and U Commons and Newtown and Zumbel and Frenchtown and Historic Main Street and Cave Springs. And he kind of went, whoa, 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 what do you got? So I gave him my material, and he's coming in July to take a look at all of our sites. And I feel confident that he will choose at least one of our sites in the St. Louis metropolitan area. It's that relationship. It's because of the brokers I have. And I told my brokers, I met with this person, and I gave his name to them, and they went after him. They were on him like there was no tomorrow. So he knows that we're going to recruit, and we're going to recruit hard for that. So again, our focus is Main Street. Our focus is streets of St. Charles. It's U Commons. It's Frenchtown. It's Newtown. It's Zumbel. It's Mark Twain Village. And it's the Route 94 corridor. It's everywhere. We're trying to push everything we can to get as much retail into this community as possible. But here we go. Here's our pivot. If I hear an ouch, I thank God my city attorney's not here telling me I can't do this. While we go after the major retailers nationwide, what we're also experiencing are local retailers who are successful. And so we took a quick look around. And if you really look at St. Charles, you'll see that we have some resemblance to Maplewood, and we have some resemblance to Del Mar Loop, and we have some resemblance to Kirkwood. And so Travis Wilson is going to go out. We've built a card. We got a promotion out there. And we're going to go to those local St. Louis area retailers, and we're going to knock on their door, and we're going to say, you're successful in Maplewood. We think that's wonderful. Stay in Maplewood. Open up a second shop on Main Street or in Frenchtown or in U Commons or in Zumbel or in streets of St. Charles. We're going to start talking to our local retailers so we can get that local flavor back into our community. We got a great local flavor. We're just expanding on that. So we're now going out. We're going to get the local retailers to come to St. Charles, hopefully open second and third operations here. We want them to succeed where they're at. We don't want to steal them from those companies, from those towns. We just want to have them share and benefit from being in St. Charles. So you will see us starting to hit very hard those retailers to benefit the retailers we already have here. Workforce. This is another pivot. We got a long way to go. As I was going to tell people, this program is kind of like, if you're familiar with Smokey and the Bandit, the theme song is from Jerry Reed, a long way to go and a short time to get there. So I'm going to try to roll fast through this. But Scott Drocknick and his team have a really good job of workforce development, workforce recruitment. What our problem is workforce attraction. And I think we've talked about this before, getting those people to come here. So one of the things that we did, well, let me show you this. This is Dave Leeser Geek Fest. One of the things you always say is I put too much stats up. I'm a geek stat guy. So just to kind of cleanse my palate, I've got to do some geeky stuff here. The city of St. Charles, since 2000, our population has grown by 17%, just over 10,000. We're still strong. We're still good growth. We're still the third largest city in the greater St. Louis metropolitan area. St. Charles County, fastest growing county in the state of Missouri, one of the fastest in the Midwest, if not in the United States. Take a look at that. Since 2000, we've gone up over almost 112,000 in population, almost 40% growth rate in this county. That's a strong growth rate. So, there we go. Here's the problem. Our current unemployment rate is 2.6%. What does that tell you? Basically, with 2.6%, we have full employment. The only people who cannot get employed are lazy, incompetent, dead, Donald Trump's hairdresser, and Hillary Clinton's campaign manager. Other than that, anybody can find a job, right? And after yesterday, maybe Robert Comey, I'm not sure. But our job is now talent attraction to get people to move here. So as you know, last year we talked about a new program. I've got to go back to workforce because workforce is important. Take a look at this also. We talk about the population growth, but what is also important is the workforce growth. If you take a look back in the 90s and 2000s, like in Florida, they had tremendous population growth. They did not have workforce growth because people were retiring there. They didn't want to work down there. We talked about 40% growth rate in population in the county. We've got almost 40% growth rate in workforce in the county. So we should be having no problem. Should be easy because we have all these people who work here. So back in 2000, I ask you this. What was the unemployment rate in St. Charles County? 5%? 6%? 8%? Average annual unemployment rate in St. Charles County back in 2000 was 2.8%. Does it surprise you? And you're sitting here going, at least for me, now Ed Schutenberg's in the audience and he knows this stuff better than I, but I'm sitting here going, I don't recall people screaming and yelling about 2.8% in the year 2000 here in St. Charles County. Maybe they were, I wasn't listening. But think about what was happening in 2000. The majority of our people were getting up and leaving and heading to St. Louis County and the city of St. Louis to work. We had General Motors, but really we did not have MasterCard here. The growth at Premier Park in St. Peter's wasn't really there yet. The growth in Fountain Lakes and Elm Point was not there yet. So in those 17 years, we have become a destination not only for housing, but for employment. Those people who are working now are staying here, and it's important to keep those people here. We were losing them every day. Now they're staying here, and we have to find something for them to stay and get them here so we can help our employers stay here. So what did we do? Well, this is what we did last year. We were trying to help people escape from Illinois. And I can say that because I'm an Illinois native, okay? I grew up in Western Illinois. My family is still there. But we did our Discover Your Future campaign. We were recruiting people to leave the state of Illinois to move here. Why? Because if you take a look at the census population, the only state in the Midwest that people were leaving was Illinois. They lost population. The rest of us gained. So we were trying to get those people to, if they're going to leave Illinois anyway, come here. And we did not attack Metro East. It was not going after Metro East. It was more 2 and 3 hours away from St. Charles. So as you know, we went to Effingham and Bloomington. And we were recruiting people to leave Effingham and Bloomington to come to St. Charles to work in St. Charles. We had 8 of our companies go with us. It was unique. It was different. Was it successful? Okay. But it was new. It was different. We knew we couldn't do the same thing. So that was our pivot from last year. So what we have to do is learn from this and see what we're going to do. So we learned from our experience, we improved the process, and we did a better job of utilizing our allies. So what did we do? We pivoted. I don't know who said it. I should have thrown it to you. So we're here to announce a partnership on September 19th of this year with the support and help of Dr. Michael Schonrock. We're going to have a St. Charles Day at Lindenwood University. What we're going to do is we are going to be at the LARC, the Library and Academic Resource Center, that great new 100,000 square foot building right there on First Capitol Drive. We're going to have St. Charles City Industries there. We're going to have our companies recruit those graduates. They're already here. They already know us. So we're going to keep them in St. Charles to have them stay here. We're thinking about doing it at another university, and I will also tell you that in 2019, we're going to go after another Illinois city. Stay tuned. I'm not going to tell you where. But stay with us on September 19th. It's going to be a career fair for St. Charles City Industries. getting Lindenwood University students. We do marketing and outreach. We do a lot of it. You've seen us on Facebook. That's Rob Dixon, who came to the OPO, and I'm going to have him speak a little bit later. Our Power Breakfast. I don't know if you know, we do Twitter, all right? We have Fountain Lakes, Elm Point. We market everything. I think, honestly, that's something that we are really, really good at. But we can do better. We can improve a lot. So one of the things that we do right now is our current tools. You saw, again, to the left is our Twitter account. Hopefully Wednesday you received our electronic newsletter. That's done with the help of the mayor and Beth Norville and Susie King, and we put that together. That goes out to over 6,000 people. That went out this past Wednesday, promoting the city of St. Charles and everybody. But also, if you take a look at what we do with our newsletter, it's not just about us. We bring our partners into us. So if you look, we have, and I'll get that, I'm sorry, I stepped ahead of myself, but I'm going to show you something we did with that. The Employer of the Year Award, that is, we do in concert with the St. Charles Chamber. That's our Facebook page. And we also highlight all the businesses in St. Charles through our Checkout St. Charles program, produced by our media department, hosted by Travis. But this is our pivot. You saw this morning our Grow St. Charles Monday Morning Minute. Hey, if you get to see me at 7:30 on a Friday morning, what's wrong with seeing me on a Monday morning also, okay? But that is something that we thought of about 20 weeks ago, because looking on the internet, I get a lot of blogs. I read a lot of blogs. I read a lot of stuff. But sometimes you just get tired of reading. You want that personal relationship. And so I did what I normally do with my staff and with Beth Norville. I walk into Beth's office and say those famous words, "I got an idea." They cringe, but they say, "Okay." So I said, "I got an idea. Let's do a video blog," or I've now found out it's a vlog. We do a vlog. Vlog. Thank you, vlog. Thank you for correcting me. All right, a vlog. And so it's Monday Morning Minute, and we highlight not only the economic development, but we highlight construction, we highlight housing, we highlight Department of Economic Development, we highlight the parks, we did a show on the 16 different St. Charleses in the United States. Okay? It's a video. It's personal. It's a relationship. It's one of those things that we're doing. This all is a part of our overall marketing campaign that we call Pattern of Awareness. We do our best to make sure that you're aware somehow, some way, either through a video or through Twitter or through Facebook or through our newsletter, that you know about St. Charles, that you think about St. Charles, that you're aware about St. Charles. I talked about before, our newsletter, we expanded that because not everybody knows, loves, understands St. Charles, but they do know and love the state of Missouri. I take that back, Mayor. Everybody loves St. Charles. My mistake. But, so, we have an article written by Rob Dixon from the state of Missouri included in our electronic newsletter. And Steve Johnson from Missouri Partnership. We interchange them. We let one do one and then they go to the next one. That's really good for us, because that shows credibility on our part. That shows that we have a relationship with people who are important to us. We're willing to invest in people like the Missouri Partnership and the Department of Economic Development because they are giving us a return on our investment. They are showing what can be done. And we're more than happy to showcase them, because when we showcase them, it helps us look a whole lot better. We're also going to improve our statewide partnerships. And I will tell you, that's one thing that I'm really committed to this year, is improving our partnerships statewide. My focus on retention was so strong, I was focusing on St. Charles and St. Charles County, and I realized I was making a mistake. I needed to do a better job making sure I was in front of the important people statewide so I can help them promote Missouri, and they can help me promote St. Charles. And I will tell you, we're really fortunate because we have a new director of economic development for the state of Missouri, Rob Dixon. He has come into play and he's doing a phenomenal job, and he's created this whole new Best in Midwest campaign. I'd love to tell you about it, but Rob is a whole lot better. So I'm going to ask Rob Dixon, our Director of Economic Development for the state of Missouri, to please come forward and talk about Best in the Midwest, a great new strategy for the state. He's been a breath of fresh air, and he's done a phenomenal job for us. So Steve Johnson doesn't feel bad, I got a big picture of you too.
Thank you. Well, thank you, David. Thank you, Mayor. I really appreciate the chance to visit with you this morning about that. The Best of the Midwest initiative really is a bit like what David's talking about this morning. It's reassessing our strategy. The world around us is fundamentally different from the last time our state really took a hard look at our economic development strategy. In fact, we haven't done that for about a decade. And if you think back to a decade ago, the economy was in a completely different position, in a different shape, and going on a different direction than it is today. We've been basically following as a state the same, more or less the same economic development strategy since that time. And so just like the city of St. Charles is going through a pivot right now, we need to take a look at how do we as a state take advantage of opportunities that are out there ahead of us? How do we move forward when things like the workforce dynamics are fundamentally different? Things like technology and demographics and just all of these different forces going on, not just here in Missouri, but really all the way around the world, and how do we take advantage of them? So we really appreciate to have David on the team with us working on the Best of the Midwest initiative to develop a new strategy for the state of Missouri to be a better partner between the state and our community partners. And we really do appreciate the chance to do that. I would also point out that Governor Parson has announced his top two priorities for his administration, and for everybody in this room and for anybody that is focused on economic development, you should be excited about those two priorities. Number one is workforce development, and number two is infrastructure. And those are literally the two pillars on which our economy and our economic development strategy are built. And it's an exciting time to work with the governor and to work on economic development, because those are the issues that are going to drive our state forward. We appreciate the chance to visit with you today. Please do look for the Best in the Midwest. We have a lot of information coming on that. I know David will keep you posted as well. Thank you all so much, Mayor. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Rob.
Here, you get a ball, too.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, appreciate that. You know, the sign of a good leader is also appointing good people around you, and he talked about workforce development. He's got Marty Leathers running that for him, and Marty's just doing a phenomenal job, and Mark Stombaugh now is also with the Department of Economic Development, so we've got a really good team with the state of Missouri. So we're going to increase our outreach even more. We want to make sure that we get in front of the people we need to get in front of, with site locators, the state of Missouri, Rob Dixon. We have we brought actually the International Division of DED into our community, and they met with LMI Aerospace and LTech Industries. And yeah, I've been in Rob's office twice. He's let me come in there, and security has not patted me down and all that stuff. It's a relationship building process. That is what we do. We want to make sure that we are part of the team doing everything we can to do that. Buildings. Here's our pivot. We're going to go into buildings now. Believe it or not, when I started this job in 2011, well, there was about 750,000 of square feet of vacancy in St. Charles. We're about basically down to zero. Now, we're going to be promoting more buildings and doing a better job of promoting buildings. Two of the buildings that we are able to promote, one of them is 3800 Charbonneau, which is over here to the lower right. It's two buildings totaling almost 375,000 square foot, 50 by 52 column spacing, 30 foot high ceilings, right on Highway 370. Cross docking is available, pushed by Cushman Wakefield. That's a good building. That's a Class A industrial building. It's less than a year old, and we're going to be promoting that also. The other building you've probably heard me talk about, which was the bane of my existence until later this year, was Air Products. Nadine Boone brought them here. Great company. They built that 98,000 square foot building 10 years ago. It's got 28-foot sidewalls, 32-foot column spacing. It's got compressed air everywhere. It's on 12 acres. 9 of it is fenced. And you can take that building, it's 98,000, and double it on the same spot. But they never opened it because the economy changed. And it sat there vacant until late last year. So now, through Benswanger, we're working with Benswanger. We're starting to promote that building now. Air Products finally has decided that they're going to push this building and put it on the market to either sell or lease, which is something we're working on. But you know, if an existing building doesn't work for you, that's okay, because we got spec building on paper. Bob Billstone has Westgate 200. If you can see it right here, that little red square at the bottom, he can build that building for you, anything you need, anywhere you want it, any way you want it, up to 200,200 square feet. 50,000 square feet, he can do it. 75, he can do it. 30-foot sidewalls, you got it. 50-foot column spacings, done. So he's ready to go. It's all on paper, ready to go, right on in Fountain Lakes Boulevard, and it's right off of Highway 370. So we've got buildings, and we've got potential buildings. But We're doing something different now. The state of Missouri has a great program called Certified Sites. It's a great way of promoting all the great sites in the state of Missouri. My problem, not theirs, my problem is to be certified site, you have to have 25 acres. I don't have 25 acres. So I've got to do something different. So we sat down with our partners and said, what do we do that we can do different? And as my wife used to work for a politician who said, originality is the art of concealing your sources. So I will say, I stole this from a community in Texas. But we contracted with Bax Engineering and SCI Engineering, and we call them qualified sites. And what we had them do is do a number of tests on certain sites in St. Charles, primarily Fountain Lakes, a few sites in Elm Point. What that qualified site includes is a phase one environmental, a preliminary geotechnical exploration, seismic site classification, slopes, flood zone, soil samples, wetlands delineation. That one right there for site one is is about three different lots. This book is for that lot. SCI Engineering and Bax Engineering did this for us. And we're going to use this to promote our sites, to basically tell those brokers and those site locators, those real estate people, that we've done the preliminary work for you. It's done. Here it is. All you have to do is say yes. So we are differentiating ourselves. You know, when they say when life gives you lemons, make a lemonade. This is our lemonade. We're working this program up. And what you will see that differentiates us from everybody else is this little thing down here in the left-hand corner. Our sites will be stamped by the engineering firms, both SCI and by Bax Engineering. They're willing to put their reputation on the line for our sites with their stuff by stamping it for us. It gives us that differentiation. It gives us that credibility. And that's how we're going to market our sites from everybody else. Redevelopment. We're almost home, folks. We're good at redevelopment. You know about Noah's Ark and what it looked like and what it looks like now. Thanks to the Cullinan Properties, and our partnership, it's a phenomenal location. It's our entry point into the city of St. Charles. We have concerts there. We have companies there. We have phenomenal things going on there. They just announced that they have started building a new 60,000 square foot mixed use office building right next to the Drury, right across from Bar Louie. It's going to be three stories high. Main floor is going to be retail. Next two stories are going to be office. It's going to really complement that place. It's going to be a phenomenal building. It'll be open by this time next year. Patty, I'm putting you on notice. It's going to be open this time next year, okay? But this is our entry point. This is important. This is the crown jewel of coming into the city of St. Charles. When you see Ameristar on your right and this on your left, you have a really, really good view of the city of St. Charles. So we understand working partnerships and doing redevelopment. What we also understand is partnerships with SSM Health and with Lindenwood University and with DESCO, because we took University Commons and made it a showcase. Not us alone, us as a partnership. It is a phenomenal place. You see retail there. You see Cedarhurst there. It is a great entry point off of First Capital Drive into the city of St. Charles. That's important to us. We understand how to do redevelopment. But folks, we ain't done. We still got more redevelopment to do. We talked last year about the West Clay Triangle. Well, we're stepping up and going to do more now. If you take a look at it, that is on the triangle of West Clay, Droste, and Deschenes. 44 acres, 26 ownership groups. We put out an RFP last year to try to help people get us together to work a plan up. It didn't work, so we're going to go back out again. And that's okay, because if you ask anybody who worked with us on University Commons and with Streets of St. Charles, it took us years to get this. Redevelopment is not easy, and it is slow at times. So we want to make sure we get it right. But we are working on that triangle to make sure that we can take that area, redevelopment, and make sure that it continues to be a show place for the city of St. Charles. That doesn't mean we're going to kick everybody out. But we're going to work with landowners. We've already talked to people in there, and we'll continue to talk with them. But we've already started our part. We are just finished Droste Road. We've widened it, we've improved it, we've restriped it. It's a better road. So we've already taken our place to make sure that we get the infrastructure in place on there, And we've also taken West Clay, basically from Deschenes west, and then later this year, we're gonna start moving east on West Clay to improve West Clay. We have already started making this a priority for redevelopment because we will improve access to it through all of our transportation needs. And now Frenchtown. Frenchtown came on the market because Susan Sams and Scott Tate and a number of people in the Frenchtown says, we want something to be done here. We want a partnership to be done here. If you haven't been to Frenchtown, you gotta go see it. It's iconic. It's really a cool place. And it has a lot of really great things going on there. And the thing that warmed my heart better, more than anything, when we met with them, is they said that they don't wanna be Historic Main Street, which is good. Historic Main Street is great. It's unique. It needs to be Historic Main Street. They don't need to be Historic Main Street too. They've got some ideas. So how are we going to do Frenchtown? Well, in 2003, we contracted with a firm out of New York called Hyatt Palma, and they gave us some really good ideas on how to redevelop that area, and we incorporated some of those. But that was 2003. So with the help of Bruce Evans and his team, we've engaged Hyatt Palma back, and they're gonna start working on a study this year to take a look at Frenchtown in that area north of Historic Main Street. But the other thing that we have done that's different than in the past is we took a look at this and we said, folks, we cannot do Frenchtown. Because while it's old and it needs improvement and needs cleaned up, if you've ever been to that part of the area, to get to St. Charles from the north off of 370, you have to go off of 3rd Street. 3rd Street is aged. 3rd Street is a lot of problems. So we've engaged Hyatt Palma to take a look at our north end, all the way, including Frenchtown, up to 3rd Street to 370, because we want to take a look at the whole area and make sure that we do this right and the teams are together. So we are starting to work on improving Frenchtown. So what does this all mean? What this means is you've got a community here that's setting the pace for investment and growth. It's not just economic development. It's Mary Lee Britton and her Parks Department using $18 million to improve our parks at the Aquatics Water Park, at the Aquatics Water Park at Wobblehorst and at Blanchette. You've got Jim Wright in our Public Works Department who's using that money also for our wastewater treatment. You've got an engineering department who's improved our water system by building a new water tower to improve water service throughout the city. You've got a community development department under Bruce Evans who's so pro-business. I will put our community development department up against anybody in the St. Louis metropolitan area. You've got Joe Ward and his team at the CVB. Nobody does tourism like we do. They understand what destination tourism is. They understand that it's a major industry with us. So we understand what's going on with that. Plus, we got an IT department that's second to none. If the mayor talked about the trolley, if you haven't taken the trolley, the other thing I will tell you is we have a trolley app. You can pull down the trolley app and find out where the trolley is and wait for it. So we are on the cutting edge with our team and what's going on. It's a relationship building. I put this picture up here because Governor Parson called my mayor less than a week after he was inaugurated and said, I'm coming to St. Charles. Can we visit with you? The governor calls and says, you want to meet? Yeah, I think we can find time for you. So this was really cool for us. So with all this, we keep saying if it's happening, it's happening in St. Charles. Well, folks, it has happened in St. Charles. It will happen in St. Charles, and it will continue to happen in St. Charles. But it cannot happen just by us. It takes our team with Missouri Partnership. It takes our team with Economic Development. It takes you to be a part of our strategy, to look long-term with us, to say, yes, I'm invested. Yes, I will be a part of this team. We need your money. Yes, we need your time. We need your expertise. We need you to partner with us to demonstrate that St. Charles continues to be the best city in the area. So thank you. dry throat. Thank you. We appreciate your time. We appreciate you experiencing this with us. If you got ideas on how we can do this and how we can go forward, we want you there because we are the best city and we want you to be a part of the best city. Have a nice day. Thank you for coming here. We appreciate it. Take care.